Hi.
Hello. How are ya?
Welcome back to my channel. My name is Chef Allison Kennedy, and today we are learning quarantine snack hacks. What does that mean exactly? Well, I'm gonna teach you three snack hacks that will take very simple ingredients and elevate them. I'm gonna use my years of experience as a restaurant chef to give you tips and tricks along the way. Now, you know, some may say that snacks are the fourth meal of the day. Well, I say fifth, sixth, seventh. There is no judgment here. We need something during this time to get us through hours of streaming pleasure. So, sit back, relax, and cue up the snack hacks.
Alright, so we're gonna start with some raw peanuts in their shells. First, you're gonna want to salt your water and bring that to a boil. Then you're gonna add in your peanuts and boil them for about an hour. This is just rehydrating them, and then we'll start to build our flavors. I like to add a plate on top to submerge the peanuts to make sure all of them are fully hydrated. While you're waiting for the peanuts to rehydrate, you're gonna wanna start kneading different things to add in your aromatics and build flavors. You could slice jalapeños into about a half inch slices. Now for some limes, I like to massage them a little bit to get those juices going. And then juice two limes. And also mince garlic. Now it's time to start building our flavors. First, some extra virgin olive oil, then add in your sliced jalapenos, your minced garlic, red pepper flakes, black pepper, and just let that cook for a little bit. Now it's time to add in salt, and that's gonna slowly release the moisture from the peppers. Then some lemon pepper, Cajun seasoning, and some chili powder. Also some Old Bay. That's gonna be a really nice base to add some heat and spice into these Cajun peanuts. Now, in order to get all the flavors, you wanna deglaze your pan with lime juice. That's gonna get all of the bits that are stuck on the bottom. Now for some Frank's Red Hot, to add a little bit of zing. All right, your peanuts have boiled. Slowly remove the plate carefully and add in your peanuts. Now you can add any more aromatics that you would like to it. Use the peanuts as a blank canvas for things that you like to add. Whenever I'm cooking stews or want to infuse a lot of flavor, I like to add some bay leaves, maybe some fresh thyme. This time I'm just doing bay leaves. And over time, this is gonna cook for about 20 hours. And it does take a long time, but it's not a lot of active work. It'll slowly start to reduce and all the flavors will really get into those peanuts. Some tips. And during the time that the peanuts are boiling, you might want to play some 90s R&B, maybe some Boys to Men, and give a little dance to the peanuts. Serenade the peanuts. Break it down for the peanuts. Or you could also make some pecans. So we're going to take some raw pecans and spread them out in a thin layer. While that's toasting up for 5 minutes in the oven, you're gonna add in some earth balance to a pan, a little bit of ground cinnamon, some salt to balance the flavor, some black pepper, sugar, as well as maple syrup. Now the idea with the salt and pepper is just gonna add a little bit of depth of flavor. You're gonna melt that down until the sugar is mostly dissolved. Your pecans are gonna come out and be toasted. And you're gonna add that butter sugar mixture to the pecans. Mix that around so it's evenly coated. And you're gonna spread it out again on the same sheet pan. You're gonna bake that for 7 minutes. And when it comes out, the sugar is gonna be a little bit more dissolved, and you just wanna give it a good mix. This way, your pecans are again evenly coated, because as the heat melts the sugar and butter, it tends to not coat the pecans as much. So you bake it for another 7 minutes, and it'll be nice and brown. Give it another mix, so again, you're coating it evenly. Allow it to cool, and as the sugar cools, it'll get nice and crispy and leave some of the pecans in clusters, which is my favorite part. So good. All right, onto our popcorn. First, you're just gonna take a neutral oil, like canola oil, vegetable oil, your kernels, and you're gonna get a small pan and with a lid on it. Cover that up, cook it over medium heat. You're gonna start seeing the popcorn kernels pop and keep on popping. And once it can't pop no more, you're gonna slowly take the lid off. Now it's time to use this blank canvas to start infusing flavors into it. I'm taking Earth Balance here, just melting that down. And I got this everything spice from Trader Joe's. I'm gonna just toast that slightly with some red pepper flakes to rehydrate the herbs and let that get a little fragrant. Just cook it for about a minute. You could add in a little more seasoning, like some Old Bay, pepper, some salt, and mix in the popcorn. Once that's mixed in, I like to take nutritional yeast. This is gonna add a nice umami flavor. Very savory. And then your popcorn is nice and infused and ready for your snacking pleasure. Enjoy.
Okay, so we have our three snacks all ready to go, and we are ready to sit down in front of the TV and veg out for hours. The reason why I picked these three snacks is because they're very pantry friendly, as far as they're all very shelf stable. Also, insider tip, you could freeze your peanuts and they will stay, and you could reheat them whenever you're ready to taste them again. And then as far as your pecans go, you're gonna want to put them in a sealed container and they should stay for at least a month. The kernels for the popcorn will stay for a very long time, but you will wanna pop those pretty frequently and eat them in a timely manner. Okay, so onto the boiled peanuts. Now, I'm from the North. I know this is a regional thing and people grew up eating this. The first time I had boiled peanuts was a couple months ago, and I have been dreaming about them ever since. And now that I know how to make them, they're something I'm gonna make for the rest of my life. I highly recommend, because you can infuse flavors. They're very easy to make. They take a long time, but that freezer trick will definitely help you out for when you want to eat them again. Let's give them a shot, shall we? Mmm. So when you're eating boiled peanuts, you want to make sure to really get all that juice that has soaked inside of the shell. They've been infused like low and slow on a low heat for hours, so there's just layers of flavor coming through. Now for the peanuts. It tastes like a salty, spicy peanut butter when you eat them. And I like to keep a little bowl set aside for your shells. That way you can snack and not have to worry about going back and forth. On to the candied pecans. Again, a regional specialty. These are Georgia pecans. And we were able to infuse a lot of balance in them by putting the salt and pepper, just like a little je ne sais quoi. Let's give them a go. I love how crunchy they are. They do have a bit of balance in them. And hey, that will keep you happy for months, days even. On to the popcorn. Now, one of my eating hacks with popcorn is using chopsticks, or I have these kitchen tweezers for plating. And the beauty of this is, A, it's portion control, so you're not just like globbing handfuls in your mouth. B, you got tiny little baby germs all over your hands, so this is great practice during these quarantine times. Let's give it a try. I love the everything spice in there, the savoriness from the nutritional yeast. Now, these snacks are amazing as is, but I want you to use this as an opportunity to further your palate and do what you want with these snacks. For example, these pecans would be great in a trail mix. Maybe some dried cranberries, whatever else you like in a trail mix, sunflower seeds. The popcorn, I like to add in some dark chocolate and pomegranate seeds if they have them. So use your imagination, use your palate to take your snacks on a journey as you indulge in this quarantine time. Snack happy, my friends. Snack happy.